And we're back, and we're playing our second game now of Line 'em Up. Was the first one fun? Was it funny? Yeah. Hopefully, the second game, I will tell you, we have thrown something in the second game that's going to make you feel lots of feels, I think. So proceed well. So we have two new contestants who made their way up on stage, and we're going to introduce them to you right now, starting with our first player. Please introduce yourself.
Hi, I'm Akemi Gamora.
You did pretty well in the cosplay yesterday.
Yeah, I'm a cosplayer. I've been cosplaying for like 2.5 years, 3 years, and I go to several cons for fun. So, yeah.
Alright. You can just describe half the people in this room.
Pretty much.
So, best of luck to you, Akemi. And who is your opponent? Who are you?
I'm Anna.
And you just described the other half of it. All right, best of luck to both of our players. Remember, the A fact has our subjects, and you guys are about to see all the facts. Here comes the facts for game number two. Pay attention. And there they are, and they are gone. Okay, they're all gone. You got them? You got them all memorized? You know what they are? Good. Okay, let's shuffle them up. And
hey, we have a special guest, Greg.
Oh, good! Ladies and gentlemen. Before we get started, we have a special guest star on Line 'em Up. Ladies and gentlemen, from Durarara, Daryl Gilboa is here! So, as I explained
before, is this Jeopardy?
You've been on enough of those for real already.
Actually, I haven't, right?
Yeah, you've been on, what, like, five now?
Four games.
He's been a contestant on four actual
What is the known voice?
Daryl, as I explained to you before the show, when the contestants make a mistake, you're just going to improv whatever you see on the screen. If you have one, just stand up, old horse style.
If they get it wrong,
then I'm going to turn to you guys and say, well, what do you think that would look like?
Oh,
and then you will, world's horse style, stand up if you have a gag and let us see it. All right, now Anna drew the high card before we played this round. So Anna, you're going to get to go first. Give me a number between 1 and 6, and that'll be our first subject.
4.
Number 4, all right. First subject for game number 2, players, is Muscle Man. Muscle Man. All right. And if you don't know the character, just know he's Muscle Man. So, we're looking for facts about Muscle Man. Give me a column and a number.
B6.
So you're telling me that Muscle Man has hair is delicious. Muscle Man's hair is, well, hang on a second. Do you want to reveal a fact in column C? No, she does not. Okay, Muscle Man's hair is delicious.
Do you know what else is delicious? My hair!
I think that's the joke. So, we'll shuffle it back up and we'll go over to Akemi now. Give me facts about Muscle Man.
B1.
Muscle Man is almost completely useless. That's not true. He serves several important roles at the park. Do you want another fact about him in C? No. All right. Muscle Man is almost completely useless.
My real muscles are not real.
My biggest muscle is failure.
Oh! Oh my God!
Oh, this is going to be a fun round, folks. We go back to Anna. We're looking for facts about Muscle Man.
B3,
you're telling me that Muscle Man tells really, really lame jokes. That is a true fact about Muscle Man. Now, give me the other fact about Muscle Man, you get a point and a prize.
C4.
Muscle Man tells really, really lame jokes and frequently whips off his shirt. True fact. Point of prize. I can't wait to see you guys. guys forget that fact and have it show up for some of our other subjects for this round. All right, we scramble the ball back up again, and we turn to Akemi again, and that's a handful of candy for you, Anna. We're looking for a new subject. Which one do we want?
A2.
All right, so for our next go-around players, we are looking for facts about Princess Bubblegum. Cartoon Network themed line them up. So we're looking for facts, and I'm assuming we have seen at least one fact about Princess Bubblegum.
Talk amongst yourselves.
B1.
Princess Bubblegum is almost completely useless. Do you want to leave it there? Or do you want to open up a fact about C and potentially give her information? Princess Bubblegum is completely useless.
I would hope if I wasn't stuck to this wall! So a joke!
Bubblegum, facts please.
C2.
Jumping over to column C. Tell me, Princess Bubblegum eats grass and licks salt.
Uh-oh.
Princess Bubblegum eats grass and licks salt. Do you want another fact? Do you want to leave it there? Leave it there. Princess Bubblegum eats grass and licks salt, Mike.
Delicious.
Anyone else got one, or do we move on?
Okay, we literally licked my hand. Okay. Sorry to everybody on YouTube that just saw my tongue.
Give me facts about Princess Bubblegum, please.
B6.
Princess Bubblegum. Hair is delicious. Yes, that is a true fact. Give me the other fact, and you line them up and you tie the match.
C2.
Princess Bubblegum's hair is delicious and eats grass and
licks. Oh, no!
We've had that. Oh, we have another joke for you.
It's why my hair's so tasty.
Okay, Anna, give me the B fact again, please.
B6.
Yep, that's right. Now give me the C.
C1.
Princess Bubblegum's hair is delicious and wiped out an entire race.
Judge, does it count?
It doesn't count in this. It does not. It does not count.
Okay,
it does not count. Yeah.
Not in this one.
All right. Yeah. So stretch my arm out across this, and all the racers are down. Die, bitches! The reason why we did not call that a fact is because, remember, Princess Bubblegum also figured out a way to bring things back from the dead, so that doesn't wipe anything out.
Oh, that's
So.
The first episode.
Yeah. So.
Ooh, we're so technical.
To wipe out means they're wiped out. They're gone. No.
They're not coming back at all.
Okay, back over to Kimi. Give me that beat back again. Yep, we know that one's right. And
C5.
Princess Bubblegum's hair is delicious and runs away from home. Princess Bubblegum runs away from home.
Oh, God. I told people they weren't supposed to chew me out.
Oh. Nice.
I didn't run away, I just got stuck to a shoe.
Anna, give me that B fact again.
B6.
Thank you. Other fact.
C3.
Princess Bubblegum's hair is delicious and is sold on the Kanto black market.
This is the real rare candy.
Yosan is gonna raise your Pokemon's defense by 5! He's gonna raise your Pokemon's defense by 5! Have some princess!
Yo, high quality hair! High quality hair! Not fine! High quality hair, man!
I think we've seen just about all the C facts except the right one. Akemi, what's the B fact, though?
basics.
Yep, that's right. That is C.
C6.
C6. Princess Bubblegum's hair is delicious and does many things for science!
That is right.
That is. High game. All right, let's jumble them all up again. The numbers stay the same. Remember what you saw, where you saw it. Anna, we need a new subject.
A6
this time. All right, folks. A6 is Ariel.
Oh.
We are looking for facts about Ariel, guys. And I will tell you, we have seen at least one true fact about Ariel. Yep.
I believe him.
I believe him.
Oh, I remember.
B5. Ariel is a relentless killer.
I assume you want to leave it there. Ariel is a relentless killer.
My dingle hopper will send you under the sea forever. And this thingamadoo, it's for stabbing. Gee, it's a beautiful day out here on this boat, isn't it? Yeah. Hey, what's that down there? Boodum. Hi, I'm Ariel. Down where it's wet, the deep blood is wet, under the sea.
I have one.
Tonight, all of you are going to sleep with us.
Oh my god, I love Flounder.
Fish are food, not friends.
Thank you very much for that.
Wait.
Oh, there's more. Go ahead.
Oceans are bad, and thanks to BP, and I like it.
Are we done?
Yeah.
Okay. Amy, compose yourself. Facts about Ariel. Remember, we've seen at least one.
B1.
Ariel is almost completely useless now. You want to leave it there? Okay. Now Ariel's almost completely useless.
Oh, he took off his glasses for this one. Here's the water.
Did you watch the movie? Everyone else solves my problems.
Oh.
Got fired.
The saddest truth.
Ariel.
Well, she's here.
B2. Ariel gives weird names to household objects. That's a true fact.
Very true.
Now, do you remember the fact we saw in column C?
C5.
Ariel gives weird names to household objects and runs away from home. You have to find out. That gives you the same prize that that Alex won in the first game, the J-Rock book. You guys will decide which ones you want of that. So that puts you into that territory. One more and you get your choice of one of the three nice prizes. You'll have to duel with that guy to figure it out. Okay, so you are still possibly going to get yourself a Legend of Legendary Heroes, but Akemi is going to have something to say about that. And she's going to lead us off with another subject, please.
A3.
All right. Next subject is Frieza.
Oh, shit.
I will tell you, we have seen at least one true fact about Frieza.
Yep.
A4?
Well, that's A.
A4.
Before and after. Yes. No. Frieza teaches about the danger of man. Do you want to leave it there? Okay. Frieza teaches about the danger of man.
These monkeys are dangerous. I'm gonna blow them up.
Beware the white man.
I'm so proud of what she's done here.
Killer.
Yes.
Another point and a prize. C.
C
C1, Frieza is a relentless killer and wiped out an entire planet. Point and a prize for you, and now you're one away from the grand prize. All right, so here we go.
The bad one.
Now, there are two choices left. One of them is one, the other one doesn't matter. So, of the two, which one would you like between one and the one you're not going to pick?
So
we're going with one. So ladies and gentlemen,
do it.
You only had the illusion.
Our next subject,
so proud of this, you guys.
And our final subject for line 'em up today is Bambi's mom.
You know who else is dead? My mom!
We are looking for facts about Bambi's mom. This is your chance to play spoiler and take the.
Now do you see why I was cackling madly at the diner?
Yes, I do.
Okay. Where are we going? I will tell you, we have seen at least one fact about Bambi's mom.
I'm scared.
B2. Bambi's mom gives weird names to household objects. You want to leave it there? Bambi's mom gives weird names to household objects.
And this long thing with a hole down the tube is a papa thingy.
Oh no, he's got a papa thing!
She doesn't talk.
I think it's a blender. Oh dear.
Anna, facts about Bambi. Anna says she's never seen Bambi. This will be a very entertaining round. Already has been for me. Where are we going here?
B5,
Bambi's mom is a relentless.
No more hunters! No more hunters! This is my vengeance.
Pay that mother.
You want to know which one ran over Grandma? It was me.
Oh my god, I love veal.
I'm back.
I'm so glad. I assumed you wanted to keep it there, right? Okay, facts about Bambi's mom.
B4,
Bambi's mom teaches about the danger of man. Yes, that is a true fact. To play spoiler and to win yourself a nice surprise, give me the fact in C.
C2,
Bambi's mom teaches about the danger of man and eats grass and licks salt. And that is a true fact. And you have won yourself and you have won yourself and you've been very, very mean to Anna. So apologize to Anna right now. Okay, that's all right. So you also get one of the J-Rock postcard books. Three of you will duel over which one you want. I'll walk away and just assume to only see one left.
Someone's going to have to get out the pudding.
Ladies and gentlemen, I haven't quite played the music.
Fine.
There's the music right there. So, folks, what did you think of Line 'em Up? Like me on Facebook, Greggo's Game Shows. Subscribe on YouTube, Greggo's Game Shows. And I found out I lost a patron today, which makes me very sad. So, Patreon, if you'd like to help support me so I can continue to do this and entertain you guys, patreon.com/Greggo's Game Shows. I want to give a big thanks to Daryl Gilbo and Laugh Out Loud.
You can link us on on Facebook, facebook.com/improvuga. Same thing with our YouTube, or write us and, you know, send us threats because of Bambi's mom.
And if you like to send us postcards, we don't have a PO box.
Would you like to say something before we go off the air?
Hi, Daryl!
Hi!
You can find me on Facebook too. You can find me.
Thanks so much. I'm Greggo. We'll see you right back here in about 5 minutes for closing ceremonies. Bye for now.